Welcome back, everybody. Some more Sapiens. This will be our final episode for the series, so let's see what we can do for learning and thinking through what we've accomplished and what we could do better in the future. I really, really have enjoyed this series, and it seems like you guys have too. I really appreciate it. The one thing, I do like that we settled relatively close to these minerals, and I can tell you, I'm very glad with the new system. With the carts, because there's no way this would be viable. Well, I mean, it would just be super slow with the older way before we got the sleds, man. It was a painful process to move large volumes of minerals around. This forest has definitely served us well. I thought it might be too small sometimes thought it might be too big, but it's definitely served us well. We can go ahead and actually go with a harvest of the parts. We got the herb garden going finally near the end here, and I think it's all propagated now. Yeah, it looks like it is. Looks like we got them all set up. But this is quite definitely. Hello. Why are you not? Oh, is this not harvestable? There you go. Thank you. Weird indeed. Yeah, they're all up. Good. But. Yeah, it's definitely nice to grab all those herbs. Even getting a few, one of each of them, is honestly enough. And I like that. It's kind of like you just have to hunt for it once and then you're done. The housing was fun. Learning messing with these designs was fun. We didn't get into much stonework. And I think next time I play, when we return to this inevitably for season 4 in some distant future, we will definitely be trying to settle. This is my hope, that we can settle somewhere that is on the edge of stone and grass. Like maybe something like, instead of settling down that way for the iron over there, we could have settled up this way for the metals over here. Like there is copper out that way, but the reason is because I think it'd be fun to build in stone. The one we didn't dabble in much, we did brick here, and the outside walls, these are stone. These are stone built walls. And we did some clay tile works and such, but perhaps even a larger focus on stonework would be fun in the future. So lots has transpired. Our hunts did well once we got past that initial stage. Pretty happy with that. Perhaps we find a different biome that's not like birch and pine forest area. Something that's got a little more tropical feel to it would be neat. I'm yet to see the purpose and value in these other colonies out here. I think it's an early start to an potentially interesting system. But the trade system where we basically have to walk over to, and I could be misrepresenting and misunderstanding it from our one run in with them. But the fact that we have to come over here and like pick up resources, there's no like trade routes that I've seen. Where you can say like, hey, you provide this, and we'll provide that, we'll exchange, you know, we could set up our own people running carts, sleds back and forth, that sort of thing. Maybe a domesticated animal to pull them, I don't know. That'd be cool if we can get into some animal domestication in the future. Have a little bit of meat animals as well as work animals, you know, something like a cow type of a creature would be fun. I think that would be great. We'll get this thing possibly finished up I've been questioned in comments whether or not this was the right design, but I think it might work. I think we might have the point all the way to the top. Be cool. Little smokestack at the top. We could even just leave it like that, and that would honestly work, except for it'd be kind of wet down at the bottom. This top here circle matches that circle at the bottom. That's why I did it this way. So hopefully that works. If not, well, we can at least put a triangle flat roof on top, if we can even reach it. I seem to remember the old one, you couldn't reach these floors up here. You wouldn't be able to build on these if you didn't have a floor below to touch, but it seems not to be the case anymore. Or maybe I'm remembering it wrong. I do like our pine forest here. Build more pine forest. Because why not? We'll propagate the forests of the pines. Bit of a random splashing of pines. Lots of pines to do. We'll go ahead and select all the ones that are up. Get them again. Nice. So we had a event there. I think that might have been friends showing up. Another village has been spotted. Hello, tribes peoples. You may be friendly. Hope you are. Wander and say hi, everybody. Yeah, this side of the forest is growing up nicely. Good. We got all the soils upgraded. We did indeed. Wunderbar. The wheat has definitely been plenty. If we got onto that earlier, I mean, you could go real long term with that. We have just an obscene amount of food right now. Like, it's really ridiculous. Bowls, however, need to not be here. So this is going to be accept none, and we're going to send these bowls over to here. Which one has the bowls? Forget which one I did the bowls on. Nope, that was the wrong one. Wrong spot. This one is for the fired bowls. And them to receive from over here. Oh, this one here. Yeah, there you go. Good, fired bowls. Okay, we need more fired bowls, so let's get that sorted out. Did we make bowls on a routine, on a repeat job? Looks like we don't have bowls on a repeat job. We have tiles, multiple repeats. Let's cancel that one. We're going to go with some unfired bowls here. So let me make sure we keep 20 of those. Good, and then we'll have a job to fire those bowls. You're fired. Fired bowls, please. Many as we can do. Let's make that an important job, because we need those bowls for making them medicines. I also want to cancel this job. Cancel this job. And cancel this job. We now have our medicine shop. Our hospital. We could actually put, like, a couple beds in here. It would feel weird maybe to have them, but no, it's okay. It's a dispensary. It's a pharmacy. Pharmaceutical locations do this. And this. Just a few beds for the sick. And there you go. Our medicine peoples. Do we have... How many people do we have assigned to medicine? 9 of them, apparently. Alright, let's get this little guy assigned there. You can be assigned there now. Planting? No. Investigating? No. Medicine? Yes. We'll take the less proficient and less skilled off there. And then we'll assign a few more. Problem with this is, with messing with these, is that we end up, it ends up being very particular about who gets to do what, and then we have too many, not enough roles, and I'm like, yeah, you definitely want to be the people to do this, and then in the auto calc, it's like, nah, I think we'll change it. And it just throws it apart, so that's all right. Lots of people are on digging. We can get you onto medicine as well. That's 5. Let's go with 6 people. Two shifts of medicine workers. Take off digging, add medicine. There you go. 6 people should be plenty. There are currently 5 roles for it, or 3 roles for it. 3. Why are you not doing your job? 1, 2, and this one's empty. What? You're doing the purple one, you're doing the orange one, you're doing the red one. Why are you not consistently doing those? I think it was 20 I told them to maintain. Yeah. In 20. 20. You're missing what? You need garlic. Garlic. Why are you missing garlic? Let me get some more garlic for you. Are we just short on garlic? Did we just not plant enough garlic plants? Oh. There's 4 of those? Oh no, there's another 8 there. They're just off-sequenced. Fine. So it's only selecting the ripe ones when I do this, right? Like, if I select this, I don't get all the turmeric. I get the 6 that happen to be ripe right now. And that's okay. That's not bad. These guys as well. Oh, didn't mean to do that. What did I just do? Yeah, I did that sort of weird. Up, let me get, there you go. Yeah, it's not bad. Our smelting, whatever, kiln works facility, I think is done well. We don't get any higher tech than that at this stage. Memelin has died of old age. I wonder what it would be like if you just left a game like this running, like, indefinitely for itself. I guess they would just die off, because they don't automatically harvest stuff, right? They'd eventually starve themselves out. That's what would happen. How's our flax and stuff? We have no flax piled, but we do have... We do have 94 flax twine still. Deepers. Piles and piles of stuff. There's hay piled there, hay piled there, and hay piled there. We got so much of it. Oh. The wagons are everywhere. That's okay. Getting those pines expanded for the future generations. Excellent. Have we not... We not invited this friend? Why are we not inviting this friend? Can somebody maybe come and do this, like, right now? Need new friends, you know? Always more friends in the village. Let's go here. Get more of these guys. Excellent. There's so much clay still piled up here. 130 of them? Where's our clay wagon? What's it doing? Why is our clay wagon not running? Oh, did I take our clay wagon off? I bet you I did. I bet you our clay wagon's one of these ones, and I moved it to do something else. Clay sled, and I did, yep. Okay, so this is going to be only clay. This is supposed to be the send items to there. Yes, and the wagon. I wish it would stay attached to the item that you're giving orders to. Receive items from there. There you go. That was the problem. Wasn't being hauled. This one's our tin, I believe, hauler. Yeah, that's a tin hauler. We got a pile of tin. We just not used up resources particularly fast. I thought it would be cool to try to go for like a population of 100, but we're just not gaining population. Not that, I mean, we've got plenty of beds. We got copious amounts of food. We have 58 population. That's one down from what we had like 5-6 episodes ago. Everybody's got lots of clothing, so they're not dying of exposure. They've got disease medicine, I guess is the word for it. They get all their medicines now, or at least I think they do. I think there might be one that's missing. What are we missing? Golds. Is there sunflowers? Or, yeah, sunflowers anywhere? No. We don't have a spot for sunflower, do we? Garlic. Why is this wood? Oh. Planks are full. there's piling planks in there. Sunflowers, are you here? Where are you, sunflowers I've never looked at? Are they... Oh, they're under flowers? They were... I thought I did not see them. No, no, it's sunflower seeds. Oh, they're under seeds, I bet. Beetroot, birch, flax. And there's sunflower seeds. So is sunflower seed, like, the, an edible item? Or is it a medicinal item? Gotta be careful with that remove item object, job. None there, please, and remove those planks. None there. Still have some open spots. Grinding away, look at that work getting done, huh? Lovely, the flowers just kind of flop over the edge of the spot. Quaint, very quaint. Yeah, we harvested a bunch of sunflower seeds, so... I mean, they should be... It should be available. Mika! Just giving birth to a baby boy. We're back up to 59. We might even hit 60. In a whole episode, we might hit 60. Oops. Did not mean to dig that. Stop digging the wrong button. Man. Commands between this game and Norland. Very different. And I keep doing things like trying to pick up the speed with tab while I'm playing Norland. Or, you know, set the speed in here with 1, 2, and 3 or whatever. Really confusing me. Making it hard, man. Such a hard life. Oh, that was quick. See how fast it moved there? Oh, hey, look. It's like the chimneys are kind of going up and over the thing. But they're also kind of blowing out sideways. There's like some of them that are going up and out. And some of them are going through the wall. Look at this. These three are pumping out the wall. These three are going up and then bending. I'm not sure too. I'm not sure why. It's fabulous. Red rock. Is there any structures we could build with red rock? Just build a little square. That's all we could do. Yeah, not really a oh, there you go. Big butchering happening there. Nice. They're so quick though. They're so efficient now with all the population up the way it is. So good. They get work done super fast. Like, we could give them this entire flax job and they'd be done it no problem this episode, where it used to be like crazy long time. There's 80 flax seeds to gather. Let's see how long it takes them to gather them. Go this guy and see if we can get all of these hunted. This one hunted. Oh, look at that. We got a chicken too. Chicken. Bark, bark. Oh, there's another one. And another one. Oh, more of them. Finally, chicken's back on the menu, boys. Lovely. Lots of chickens. He likes our chickens. Me a chicken. You're not a chicken. Nice, though. We got lots there. Losi is now an elder. Yeah, the birth rate isn't anywhere near high enough to keep population growing. You get to kind of this point, and I think it, like, tapers off. It might be intentional. Might be by design that it does that. I don't know. But I think we've covered most of the content that is in the game at this point. I'm sure. I know there's more coming. Now he's looking to expand the into new things. You can check their link to the official website in the description. All the videos have. There we go. I was gonna say there's supposed to be a village there. Well, look at this. What the heck? A tin and a copper deposit just like spawned there with them. That's a little weird seeming, but that's definitely what it did. This village spawned those ore deposits. Alright. So these guys are what? We could trade metals works with them, maybe? They legit do work, right? They look it. They've gathered stuff. They're actually going around and picking up grass. It's drying. So I mean there's definitely more going on. They got a little storage here for what is this? Bronze hammers. Bronze spears. Yeah, they're exporters of tools. Runs chisels. That's what they do. That's cool. And axe heads. Yeah. They just, each of these little villages have, or each of these things has like an its own little strange pile. Crucibles up the wazoo here. Oh yeah, look at that. A plant spawned right over top of these gooseberries. The rock rather spawned right over, or the gooseberries spawned under one or the other. I guess that's how he deals with the generation of villages. Nice. Yeah, these guys would have all the copper bronze works we could purchase off them, I imagine. That's kind of neat. It's not ridiculously far away for that one. We'd want to build a, well, that is pretty darn far actually. We'd want to build a road there if we were going to do something with that. But not something for this season. Maybe we'll see how the thing fleshes out. This is actually a game that would be very interesting to play multiplayer. What are we missing here? Logs? Seriously? Seriously, we chopped up all the logs. Alright. Get 76 more of them chopped. That's 76 trees that have, what, 3 or 4 logs apiece? Let's go, boys. Let's do this now. Because I want that project. The project has to be done today, so prioritize that chopping. Everybody get to it. Oh yeah, they're just about done the flax harvest too, because they gave them a ridiculously large flax harvest for absolutely no real reason. See what I mean? You get to the point, for me it's at a point where the game has given us all that it can give, and anything at this point is just rinse repeat. Now it's probably my lack of creativity perhaps that I'm not, you know, finding more enjoyable, entertaining ways to do things, but I do love how they played it. It's really nicely done. synchronized axe chopping. You're chopping with a hand axe when there's a proper axes. How about you use the ones with the sticks? Be faster. Look at, there's like four or five hand axes sitting right here. Do we have bronze hand axes made? We have bronze hand axes, but none of them have actually made the axes yet. Okay. Those are pickaxe jobs to maintain. Those are hammer mace jobs to maintain. Well, we haven't made the bronze axes, so let's do the bronze hatchets. Let's maintain 20 of them. There you go. And these are bronze pickaxe heads. I haven't made any of those. Go ahead and try to maintain some of those. Actually, just make 20 of them. Tiles and tiles. We'll undo one of the tile jobs. We can make axe heads. Yeah, let's just maintain 10 axe heads and 10 bronze pick heads. Right here. Go. We got ingots made. Turn them into those. There's some bowls being made. Axes, tiles. Yeah, we definitely need to increase our productivity on smelting if we wanted to produce larger volumes. There you go. We get a bunch of sticks down apparently from each of these, which is weird. I thought we already picked the sticks, but sure. Yeah, see there, you should be faster with chopping those trees. There you go. That was an easy peasy. So yeah, they do get branches down. I somehow didn't think they did, but they do. If we harvest the branches first, we get a second batch when we cut them down. All right, I mean, it makes sense. You're only harvesting like some of the branches, and then oh no, maybe not. Nope. Okay, I'm not mistaken. So we are only getting, okay, some of those trees must have not had their branches taken down. So if you didn't take the branches down, cutting the trees directly seems to give you the branches. Or maybe it's a percentage chance thing. And I think it's probably a fairly consistent supply. Let's get them logs over here, people. Let's go. Get all these things done. Right now. Right now. Hustle, hustle, people. There's lots of light. There's a big torch under it. Go, everybody, go. Run them logs. Log driver learns to step lightly, it's whirling. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's bedtime. That's what happened. I was gonna say, what? It got too dark for you to walk across the road? No, they're just heading to bed. Look at them all swarm into the beautiful bunkhouses. Is somebody coming to sleep in these ones? Nope. Nobody's in the medicine rooms. Are you going to? No, you're off to go to the other beds. That's interesting. They like social. They like big social spaces, I guess. Well, that's lovely. Oh, got a breezy storm coming up. A large thatch roof has been damaged. Another large thatch roof has been damaged. Oh boy. Quick repair, repair. Repair those damages. Oh goodness. My damaged walls. Wait, where's the other damaged one? Oh, it's right there. Makes sense. That one would just get torn apart in a windstorm like this. Oh, the graphics are messy. Just bouncing. The trees are just flailing around. I am on fast speed, so. There you go. Looks hilarious in fast speed. She's looking up like, I don't know if this is safe right now. I feel like I'm on one of those construction YouTube videos about the why men die sooner than women. The boys seem to be building this a little precariously. There you go, it's getting up there though, look at that. Very nice. Alright, and I want to use more of these pieces on the top now to finish it off. I think. Uh-oh. Yeah, we're in get up there, but how do I... How do I get it to link? Can I not build that? Yeah, I can build that high. Nope, what was that? What was that for? I didn't tell you to build there. What are you doing? That's not the button I thought I was pressing. This is a little awkward. It's not really letting me link to the top tile. They can go across the room like that. If I go over there, if I can get one of them to link. There. And then rotate it. What is it? X, Y? Nope, it's not going to link that. Not liking that at all. Oh no! Can't place them this high? Is this just like a physical limit of how tall you can get buildings or something? I don't know. Could I attach something on top of this? Oh, maybe I can't. No, it was linking there. That would make sense. Because I did get one to attach. Oh, that's what it's done. Oh, that's not what I want it to do at all. I want it to attach there, but I want to... That's rotating the piece. How do I get that to link? Maybe closer instead of further away. Oh, okay, hold on. Snap to somewhere, please. Nope. As soon as I hold the right mouse button to rotate it, it stops. Rotate 90, X, Y, and Z. I just can't get it to rotate the proper way. It'll sit there. How about if I place one there and then attach one, like, try to attach one to this side. So, like, is opposite that? Hold on. This piece up top, I want to tell it to not be built. I want to see if I can, like, find it a way to get it to attach onto the other. This is annoying. See, the Z thing spins it upside down. Right, I can attach there, but I can't get round. It won't link to the top of those pieces. If I take this one out and I put in a little flat one, how about that? How about instead of that we go like this? No, I want wooden walls. A little one right there. They put one up there. And then try to attach those on. Well, that's interesting. You can attach that, but not on this. Well, I don't hate that. Except for they're going to be backwards if I do it that way. So. There, but it was the wrong way. Oh, this is very frustrating. It's not quite optimized for high builds yet, huh? It's just this upside down piece is not accepting a piece on the bottom. It's not letting me put a link to that bottom unless it's outwards. If I put that there, that's the inside piece. See? Can't get it to face the other way. That's the problem. It won't face the other way, and those angular pieces are locked to a specific coordinate. Shift to disable snapping, huh? This way? Oh, that's not good. Oh. If I don't snap them, then they won't fit on right. Bizarre. Yeah, I cannot get it to attach from this side. Oh, that's weird. Yeah, so it's going to have to be this way. Because I can't get them to rotate the other way. There's no commands to do that. But it'll be an interesting twist. It'll still work because we'll be able to get these on top then. See? Well, that's not attaching properly. What the heck is that? How's that the spot that it attached to? This is weird. Joy of today. Yeah, I thought it was linking to the top of that, but yeah, there. And that's attached, isn't it? Is that properly linked onto that? Seems like it is. And then that will. There. 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 And there. I could actually, like, remove some of these. That's interesting. Let's remove this one. Little venting spot. Ah, I like it. Wasn't what I planned, but I like it. It'll have a little smoke outlet. I like it. All right, let's get these going. Are these, oh, too difficult to get to. So there is a limit to the height, huh? All right. Oh boy. Can't. We could do stairs. Two by three single. How do I get up there? Why are you not linking up there? That's that might work. There we go. Make these happen, people. Let's go. See if that works. this is a very convoluted way to end things off today. We'll get this build done, and that'll be it for today. It might be a little longer. A little bonus length for you. Some of these are growing up early. Interesting, and these ones didn't get cut. Why? I missed them somehow, or they weren't growing up yet? They weren't full size yet? We've got some soil that needs mulching. I like that everything's gone beautifully green again. It's lovely. Nice. Oh, that's why they were slower. Because the soil had gone, had been depleted a little, and we didn't get to it and notice it in time. Oh. Very lovely. Could also mulch up these guys, to be honest. That's a never future thing. Alright, so how did that work? Okay, now we can reach the top. One is fine, it looks like. We'll cancel that one. Because it looks like we can reach the top of those now. From that stairwell. Oh, maybe not this one. Ah, nope, we can't get to this one. Okay, so don't cancel that one. Don't remove that, please. Get it built. Priority build. You need to get up there in order to get to the last guy. Finally, I need scaffolding. So you can go three floors up. Three levels up, but you can't go four. Makes sense. Got to be a limit at some point where they can't just hover. Levitate up there. Very productive little town. It actually looks very different when this forest isn't really tightly crowded around the edge. I love it. I like our little village. We made it 60 population. We got 60 population! I wonder if we could recruit from those other villages. I never thought about that. Just go recruit all their population over here and get them to join us. Not bad. Let's see how well they do on this build. Didn't take them long to get those stairs in. They should be able to get all the parts up there to get that thing going. Yeah. That actually doesn't look that bad. Kind of looks cool from up there, looking from the inside. Maybe I'm just finding the silver lining and the fact that I couldn't get it to work that way. Ale was burned. Oh, don't burn the ale, man. The little kid's name is Ale. And we're back down below 60 again. Sakila has died of old age. Sorry, Sakila, to laugh at you, but I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing at me. About you. Maybe we need to build a little church house and preach fertility rites, and then there'll be you know, lots more babies. That must be it. Go have more babies. Babies are awesome. Yeah, it'll combine at the top beautifully. Look at that. That's gonna be awesome. Very happy about this. Echo has had a baby boy. Back up to 60. A very slow climb to growth status here. A little more green going there. Maybe a little more around here too. Since we've been making mulch like forever. Feels like as a review sort of statement, feels like we could do with having I didn't realize these things still here. Storage. We could do with having a little less excessive volume of things. Like we produce way more mulch, way more food, way more grain than these 60 people could use. They're never strapped. They're like a modern folks, never really pressed for their daily needs. Early on, it can be tough for a little bit, but it's very minimal. Once you know how it works, it's pretty minimal. Them blank planks in, I love it. One more. Good. Good. Good mitering work of them. Nicely done. Oh, that one as well. Good. We got one more over here. That was quick. Then we just have to take down the stairs. Boop. They place it, then they shove it into place. I love it. And there it is. All done. We can take this top stairwell down. That would be appreciated. We could probably take the bottom stairwell down, honestly, at the same time, because even if they take the bottom down first, it'll probably be pretty easy for them to reach that one, and it'll float. Is it gone yet? How's it not gone yet? Oh, there we go. More peace? No. How's that not gone yet? They're taking apart the bottom one. All the both stringers are gone, and all the treads are gone, but they're still there somehow. Tell me that's not going to get stuck there. Is there something more they have to do? A little weird. Maybe they have to pick up the junk off the work site. Probably they have to clean the work site first for it to work. I love how there's like people just throwing their shirts off here. Auto assigning is working. It'd be nice, like you could set up an automated thing. It'd be really cool if you could set up a little village and have an automated structure set up for it and then go play as another village nearby. That'd be cool. That'd be a neat thing to do. Like you set up this little village and it's got, you know, it's really good at lumber works and you can just set up like repeat orders, you know, like a zone where they always harvest and a zone where they always do whatever, you know. That'd be cool. Maybe that's outside of the scope of the intended scope of the game, but look at that. Look at all these beautiful bronze axes we have. Lovely. They're a great bunch of people, these Sapiens and Solariaville. I kind of like that, how that turned out. The little gazebo smoky top. Yeah, so this triangle piece does not fit straight on top of that triangle piece because if that's all there is to connect to, because they don't link, they can't They can't latch to the bottom of that, which might make sense. I don't know. Structurally, maybe they don't. They wouldn't have support. I don't know. But that's going to be it for today. That's going to be it for this series. Our beautiful village. Remember when there was 8 of us sitting around a set of trees saying, let's make a town. That was us. Now we're this. We could go on forever like this until somebody invents something new. Like, I don't know what new they would invent, but we'll see when the upgrades happen to the expansions, or not expansions, the new versions roll out and the updates. I'll be interested in seeing after an update or three and see what more can be done. Summertime already, huh? Hopefully. Thanks everyone for joining us for this series. I really do appreciate the huge feedback we got on this one, and a lot of people enjoyed it. Doing well, so we'll definitely do more of this content in season 4 sometime in the distant future. Other series in the works. I'm planning a Going Medieval series to replace this one in the early morning, well, for me, 6 a.m. time slot central, GMT minus 5 or 6 or whatever we are. So what would that be? Noon GMT, somewhere around there, is when our city builder series plays, and then more of a grand strategy 4X-ish type of games I run in the evenings when we have them. And the next one is starting up tomorrow as the release of this, so right near the end of August in 2024 we'll be hitting Norland. And that'll be the next series starting up. It'll be an evening series, so instead of 6 a.m., it'll be 12 hours later, released daily. The episodes are already starting to publish, they publish tomorrow. A bunch of them are uploaded. A number of them are uploaded to get us started with, so it'll be exciting to see you guys respond to that game. Very different game, very much more about the personnel management of a few rather than your whole colony. There is a bunch of people, legless in this case, in Norland's case, running around, but yeah. You get to manage like a handful of lords and try to keep them out of trouble and try to conquer lands and stuff, but with a city builder twist to it. So it's kind of an in-between stage game. So that'll be our 6 p.m. And then I'm looking to start up, it's the first time I mentioned it, I think, but I'm looking to start up, for those of you who are here, a new series on Going Medieval. That was a big one on the channel ages ago as well. And I'd like to return to it because so much, like most of these really well done indie games, so much continues to happen because the developers, like the guy who made this one, it's a passion project and they do really take their time to do it, but they take the time to do it right, and it's really an enjoyable game. I've seen no bugginess, no issues that are, you know, of major concern. Yeah, the smoke is coming through the wall, but that's not exactly a play breaking issue. So there's a little smoke build. See, it'd be nice if the smoke billowed up out of that. But, you know, down here we can imagine it is. I like this little build. I'm glad somebody reminded me in the comments to try again on making the round structure. So that smoke seems to be going back straight up, whereas this stuff is coming across. Maybe it is working somewhat. Huh. Maybe it is. That's cool, though. Oh, there goes somebody carrying a baby. Oops, they had a little baby thing on. Yep, they had a little baby strapped to them. That's awesome. Little fuzzy baby. Wrapped up in the furs. Nice. Well, thanks everybody so much for joining me. I do appreciate all the likes and all the views. You really do support the channel amazingly well when you do that. Look at the top of that. That's great. Next series, like I said, Norland in the evenings, and then we'll be going Medieval will be starting up this week. I am trying to do some rearranging of some stuff at home. We got some, hopefully getting the office positioned properly by within the next 5 or 6 days. So the office should have enough renos done on it in the next week to be able to get my desk and everything back in there. And our little Hannah is homeschooled, so she will also be needing some space. So I got to get that space in the office for her. So daddy-daughter office is what it's going to be. So. But thanks, everyone. Have yourselves a great rest of the day. We'll see you again either in the next series or in some more Sapiens when we return to it. Hope you do check out some of the other stuff on the channel. Links down below. Have yourselves a great rest of the day. See you in game.